जय श्री माता जी एवरीवन, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। लेट अस बाउ डाउन, डिफ्लेट द बलून्स ऑफ आर ईगो एंड सुपर ईगो, रेज आवर कुंडलिनी एंड टेक अ बंधन। We seek permission from Sri Ganesha, who is our mother herself. Oh Sri Ganesha, please allow us to meditate and to start a beautiful day with the vibrations of your positivity, wisdom, and innocence. Now let us join our hands and recite this morning prayer as a collective, Pratah Smarmami Prithi Sanspurdhatmatattvam Satchit Sukham Paramhansa Gatim Turiyam यत् स्वप्न जागर सुषुप्ति मवैति नित्यम् तद् ब्रह्म निष्कलमहम् न च भूत संगः। ओ मदर, थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग अस दिस मॉर्निंग प्रेयर। विच रिमाइंड्स अस that we are not this body, that we are the divine love, that we are a part and parcel of you. O Mother, please bless us that we keep this in mind all through the day and also We see others as a spirit. That we always be aware that the divine love is there in every single human being. Slowly let us keep both our hands on Mother Earth. Let us say Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Mantra once. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devyai Namo Namaha. O Mother Nature, O Mother Earth, please take away all the negativities which are inside me. Which are stopping my spiritual growth. Oh, dear Mother, please bless us and guide us. So that we live in a balanced way, not harming any of the natural resources. Bring our attention to Muladhara. Let us seek clearance for our left Muladhara. Keeping left hand on lap. Shri Nirmal Ganesha Sakshat. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Nirmal Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devyai Namo Namaha. Mother, I am innocent. Moving our attention to center Muladhara. Both hands on lap now. Sri Ganesha Gauri Sakshat. Om Tvameva Sakshat. Sri Ganesha Gauri Sakshat. Sri Adishakti Mataji, Sri Nirmala Devi, Namo Namaha. O Sri Mataji, O Sri Ganesha. Oh my Gauri, please make me innocent. Slowly moving our left hand to Mother Earth. Requesting clearance for right Muladhara. Sri Kartikeya Sakshat. Om Tvameva Sakshat. Sri Kartikeya Sakshat. Sri Adishakti Mataji, Sri Nirmala Devi, Namo Namaha. Sri Mataji, please make me worthy of your appreciation and love. Sarva Rakshasa Hantri Mantra. Om Tvameva Sakshat सर्वराक्षसहन्त्रे साक्षात् श्री आदिशक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देव्यै नमो नमः। श्री माताजी, प्लीज डिस्ट्रॉय ऑल द ईविल इनसाइड मी, ऑल द सिक्स एनिमीज ऑफ द सोल। मदर, प्लीज डिस्ट्रॉय देम। Both hands on lap. Moving our attention from Mooladhara, which is now very healthy and strong, giving us a strong base, and Sri Ganesha Tattva is now supporting us. To raise a few more strands of our Kundalini Mother, which will enlighten all our chakras and will awaken all the deities, giving us the positivity to walk out in the world and spread the positivity of Sahaj love everywhere we go. Now, keeping our attention on Vishuddhi and Sahasrar, we will be listening to Mother's talk, continuing the one we were listening yesterday. We'll surrender to our Mother and request her to work on us, our children,
There is no other mood that is enjoyable to the spirit that does not relate to God. There is no mood which one can enjoy. Even bibhatsa, the mood of bibhatsa is grotesque. Even that mood one enjoys, one can listen to when they see the filth and dirt, the left side. It's so scientific. Our music system is extremely scientific because it was taken in the form of this music when actually the kundalini moving into different, the sapta swaras. These seven swaras are built in our seven chakras. We start with sa, then re, ga, ma, mother, pa, da, ni. My name also starts with ni. These seven swaras are built in with seven notes, and there are vikrutis, vikrut saras, which are the side, other, chakras that we have to make about 12 swaras. But nobody understood the real meaning of music. Sharada, the goddess of Saraswati, is the one who carries the message of Virata within us and tells us how to sing. She tells us what is appealing to God. How these ragas were made also, just think of it. Because first they chose the notes, the aroha, avrohas, the going up and down, which was appealing to God. So the melodies were created. Melodies are fixed. You cannot change the melodies, the notes, because they found out that at this point the spirit awakened. On the vibrations they found out. They found out that when they sang this way it worked out. The veena they played and they found out the exact swaras. Exact swaras, which would really make you feel nice. Now you know that those people who have come from the West don't understand any Indian music on the mental level. But they understand at the spiritual level because their spirits get filled with joy and the vibration starts flowing. The sense of music, this depiction of music was done by Shri Krishna. It is he, the one who taught tala. Of course, we can say that Shiva is the one who dances the tala. But the one who depicted it for human beings, who gave the message to the world how the tala should be, is Shri Krishna through his dancing movements. He kept the tala all the time. Like the way he stands itself suggests how he kept the tala. And he played the murli also to suggest that music is what God's love is. His music is suggestive of God's love that suits you, that clears you, that makes you happy, that makes you, gives you joy. And that's why he suggested through his singing, through his music. He never wrote any poetry, did he? He never wrote any poetry as such. But when he spoke, in Gadya, in the prose, it became Gita. Just when he spoke, it became Gita. Of course, people have tried to spoil quite a lot of it, the rhythm, which I feel sometimes when people recite it. But still, we must say when he really created it, it was for human beings to create poetry out of prose. Out of prose, he made it communicable. Because people could first only understand the music, the rhythm of the music. They didn't understand much words and things, but he made it possible. Even in Quran, if you read, the few words before starting every chapter, nobody understands. They are all nothing but mantra bijas. But they put it there. They knew people won't understand, but he put it there because people would understand. All these things you may not understand. You may not understand me either, possibly. But whatever they did was for your hita. This is what happened at the time of Sri Krishna, that he established the concept of hita. Because it was said that you must speak the truth and you must speak the thing that is sweet, priya. Satyam bruvet, priyam bruvet. It was the message of Sri Krishna that you must speak sweetly. Those people who have got a proper Vishuddhi Chakra speak very sweetly. Their voice has that enchanting method of capturing the hearts of people and not debasing them but elevating them. So he said, you must do it sweetly. That was his main theme. Everything he did so sweetly that he created a leela out of his dreams. It was a leela that he created. He said, this world is not a place where you should be serious, you should be sharp, you should be tense, but it's a leela. Just see the leela, the drama. The whole is a drama. So the whole thing is very sweet. If you see the whole world as a drama, it becomes a sweet thing. The sweetness of it, even if you see a person trying to be funny, you get a joy out of it. If you know it's a drama, you don't get worried. If somebody comes and murders somebody, you know it's all fake. It's a drama. It's a drama going on. And that's what he told people, that the whole thing is a leela, so that people should not get into serious moods and actually start acting in the drama in the real way. Like you see, you appoint somebody as Shivaji Maharaj, and there is somebody coming from the other side and he takes a sword and he really hits the fellow, then you say this Shivaji Maharaj actor is no good. He gets absolutely involved into the thing and he hits the other person. So it's a drama, and he made it into a leela. Leela because it's a drama, no doubt. But when you get realized, you start seeing the drama and the play. And the whole thing is, you must have seen that most of the Sahajogis are always laughing because they see the way things are happening. Even when they see a guru misbehaving or something, they just feel like laughing how absurd it is. Like somebody came today to talk to me and he told me, Mother, I have been to all kinds of nonsensical things. And he was just laughing. He said, I laugh at them now, what I did. He said, I went to one guru who used to give name to people, say this nama, that nama. I made such efforts, I went to people, recommend my case, because he was not so rich, you see, so he was never got the name. And he was saying, give me the name, I must have the name. And the guru was saying, no, you have to wait still. He said, I poured so much money in his seva peti, and which were large seva petis were put, I did everything. But he would not give me a name. And ultimately, when it came to that, he said, all right, I'll give you a name. And he gave me a name, which I started taking. I really became mad after that. I started getting headaches, this, that. Then he said, all right, you have to suffer. If you don't suffer, you must go through it. You asked for the name, so you have it. And when he came to me, he was looking nothing like nothing on earth, I tell you. In a very funny shape he came to me. But now he's completely cured. I could not even recognize him the other day, I just saw him. I said, oh God, are you the same person? So he said, Mother, now I laugh at all these things and I just see that how people are stupid. To go to these false people, follow false ideas and false conceptions, and how they are missing the point. And he asked me a question, have they to go to that limit of destruction to come to you? I said, I don't know about them, what they have decided. But it is true that people are so stupid that they take to all these ideas and all these negative things much more easily than to the positive thing, because of the Vishuddhi chakra being spoiled. If your Vishuddhi chakra is not spoiled, your hands are working better. Many people who get realization do not feel vibrations in the hand because their Vishuddhi chakras are not all right. Now what does that mean, that your Vishuddhi chakra is not all right? First of all, by temperament, you are not a collective person. By temperament, you are not a person who enjoy collectivity much, like people who are fussy. I want this, I want that, I want to sleep on a proper bed, I must have this, I must do that, this kind of a I. Those who have too much I in them, because both ego and superego start from this Vishuddhi chakra. You see, a man who is an egoistical person is not able to see the collectivity at all, because he is separated with the rest of them. His ahankara covers his being so much that he cannot enjoy the collectivity. Now, you see, Shri Krishna lived with whom? With gopis, little boys. He went and used to look after his cows, just looking after the cows. None of these incarnations you'll find were interested in rich people or anything. He went and stayed with people who were very ordinary from the worldly point of view. And there he played, and there he did all these tricks of sweetness. He used to steal the butter. He used to steal the butter. And many people who are criticizing him always say, oh, he was a thief. Yes, he was a thief. He was the thief of the thieves. So he used to steal the butter, because this butter was taken to Mathura by these ladies to get some money. And that was giving more health to all these horrible rakshasas who were in Mathura. So he didn't want this to go there and give them this good health. And the best thing was to steal the butter so they don't get it and they starve on their, they have their deficiencies of the vitamin A and D, you can call it, and that they suffer from bad throat and they have no strength in their hands when they pick up their swords. So this was the way to hit them so that they could not fight the forces of good. So in that he proved that a higher goal is to be achieved by giving up smaller, silly, stupid goals. The hita is the main thing, because when he said that you don't speak the truth, otherwise people will be hurt. All right, so what should you do? You hurt the people, so you don't speak the truth. Or you speak the truth, you hurt the people, so both cannot go together. Like, if I tell somebody, oh, you are so bad, that person gets hurt. Now, if I don't tell that person is lost. So what to do? He found out the solution, so he said, satyam vade, hitam vade, priyam vade. He put the word in between as hita. The word hita means good to your spirit. Whatever is good for your spirit. Hita word means good for your spirit. It has nothing to do with material thing. It means for your spirit. For example, if I tell somebody that you should not do that, he may feel bad today. But if he recognizes that mother is telling me for my good, he will do it and he will gain by that in his hita. Or else if he does not do it later on, supposing I don't tell him and if he doesn't know about it, or even if I tell him he does not do it, he is going to feel bad. so that it is not priya to his spirit, it is not priya to him. So if you do something that is the hita of a person, sometimes you have to tell a person. Sometimes it may look very, very painful. The other day I told somebody that you don't cure anybody because you are not strong enough to cure. He felt very hurt. So then I said, all right, go ahead, you better cure others, but don't come back to me. Then he'll land up in a lunatic asylum. But when he'll land up in the lunatic asylum, then what will he say? Was that for his hita that I said? Will he be then angry? So ultimately, if you say the hita, say, saying is the part, not doing, say. You say the hita with your Vishuddhi chakra, then ultimately it becomes priya, means it is light. So you say a thing which is good for the spirit, otherwise you just don't say. But people just say to others to correct them because they are aggressive. It should be done in love. Hita means done something in love. If you want to say something to someone in love and you feel it is necessary, and the third condition, you must have adhikara. You must have the right to say it to the person. If you don't have the right, you just keep quiet. Let God look after. You are not in charge of anyone. But if you have to say to someone in love, and if you have an adhikara, then you have to say it. If you don't have the adhikara, you should not say anything to anyone unless and until it is absolutely priya to that person, involving his hita. This is what he put, that you should not do any anadhikar cheshta, means you should not do something unauthorized. Like, I would say somebody comes to me and says that, where is that person whom I want to murder? Then what is the truth? Should I tell him, all right, this is the truth, you go and kill that person. According to the strict government law it may be. I don't know if it is. I don't understand the government laws at all, or the human laws, but it is not. Then what you have to tell him? You just keep quiet. He has no adhikar, he has no right to ask you or to get this information from you. You just keep quiet, I don't know. Then he may beat you, do anything, you just say, I don't know. It is anadhikar cheshta. It is done many a times, people who are, say, great nationalists who fight for their country, and people want to extract information from them. They suffer, but they will not give the information. Not out of fear, but out of love of their fellow men who are fighting for the freedom of their country. This has been done in our country many a times. So you don't speak something which is not the adhikara of another. He has no right to ask this question. Like that, one has to be very discreet, and that is what Shri Krishna has given us, his discretion. Many people ask me, Mother, then in this situation what should I do? In that situation what should I do? That means the person has not developed his Vishuddhi chakra to be discreet. He has not evolved, he's not mature enough, he's still asking me questions. In the nirvikalpa state, you don't ask me any questions, you know exactly what is to be done. When to shout at somebody, when to be quiet, when to be silent, when to say something, and how far to go.
Silent meditation for a few minutes, trying to imbibe Mother said to us. With our right hand, let us give vibration to our Vishuddhi chakra. Oh, Shri Mataji. Please clear our Vishuddhi chakra. O Shri Krishna, please give us the sweet tongue and the intelligence to deliver our message in a positive manner. Thank you, everyone, for your vibrational support this morning. May we all be in Nirvikalpa state. Have a blessed day. Jai Shri Mataji.